full of home cooked food. Just got off the phone with God Mom complaining she put too much of her Indian spices. Real hot, but just so cool. She pushed me to pull this medical resident school kid through. My pager goes off, the emergency room with a new admission. Patient was an elderly woman with an unstable condition. Finished the last spice, then left the rest in the fridge. In less than a minute, I met her bedside with all of my questions. Less than a second, it took to realize we didn't need guessing. Her breathing was labored, her knees were pressing her chest. And she had a history of long-standing dementia, along with a long list of other conditions. And standing right next to her, the family, some tearful, others firm and focused. Full coach status, so I made sure we tubed her throat for the fifth time this year. The end is near, it's near the end, and her situation clear. She was rapidly deteriorating, most probably aspiration, severe incapacitation. Regretful to tell her family, the loved one may not make it. They still ask for life, sustaining measures with a blood pressure drop. I placed a central line and started those damn presses.
Sometimes I don't know, I feel this strain. Feel no pain, but as I look into the eyes of my patient, they're laying. I know that she's about to die, hope she feels no pain. You can ask all my people, they feel the same. Caught in the middle of things, that's why we feel so drained. If he's on his deathbed, I hope he feels no pain. And when he passes away, I hope I feel no pain.
Never cease to amaze me, even at an advanced stage. My godmother's in the kitchen, managing pots filled with chicken, conducting a symphony of different delicious dishes. The scent alone makes me want to take the top and just lift it, but not before I get my hand slapped by that demanding chef. I'm always snooping around, sniffing what she's planning next. She's making sure I don't compromise her space again. She brushes me out of the way, I can't have no taste again. Damn, I'm getting paced again, my heart starts to race again. It's the same patient, older now, she's way past facing death. I jump on the patient's bed and start with the chest compressions, cracking the brittle ribs as my senior defibrillates her. It takes us only one shock, we get it back. Let's call the family up, 2 a.m. and get him back. The cardiac rhythm, hemodynamics, we got him back. Even though I don't know how long we could hold that from going flat.
Sometimes I don't know, I feel this strain. As I go about my day, I feel no pain. But as I look into the eyes of my patient, they're laying. I know that she's about to die, hope she feels no pain. You can ask all my people, they feel the same. Caught in the middle of things, that's why we feel so drained. If he's on his deathbed, I hope he feels no pain. And when he passes away, I hope I feel no pain.
And one end is my attending, reciting what sounds foreign. Despite her best efforts, ain't no fighting the failing organs. At the other end is that patient's loving husband who tries to explain he doesn't want any hospice comfort. He doesn't want to pull the plug and let her go under by any and all means. Wants us to resuscitate her. I'm caught in the middle, riddled with questions with no answers. Do no harm, it's that oath that I won't tamper. But I know my own fam will look at me as their only doctor, only for proper guidance. Should this happen to my godmother, only God knows how much I love her. I put no one else above her. Sprinkle some false hope above that grim prognosis. Then I'm reminded of all the futile interventions from son to physician, frustrated by this transition. Counting each deep breath, I walk with each step. The only thing left to give is a gift of a peaceful death.
Sometimes I don't know, I feel this strain. As I go about my day, I feel no pain. But as I look into the eyes of my patient, they're laying. I know that she's about to die, hope she feels no pain. You can ask all my people, they feel the same. Caught in the middle of things, that's why we feel so drained. Deathbed, I hope he feels no pain. And when he passes away, I hope I feel no pain. Sometimes I don't know, I feel this strain. As I go about my day, I feel no pain. But as I look into the eyes of my patient, they're laying. I know that she's about to die, hope she feels no pain. You can ask all my people, they feel the same. Caught in the middle of things, that's why we feel so drained. If he's on his deathbed, I hope he feels no pain. And when he passes away,